Can't believe I made it. It is so bright. Oh my god. What is going on, guys? It's your boy Norton Chat or FaZe Rain. You know what? This is just Norton Chat because it's my Norton Chat channel. Ain't no FaZe Rain. This looks like I did it in the same day, right? Because like I'm just back from the gym, have the hat on, you know what I'm saying? You guys are thinking, oh, you just recorded it the same day. Well, you know how I have proof that I didn't record it the same day and that this is a brand new day? You know what I'm saying?
God damn, bro. Are you kidding me? Who loves their dog this much?
Who loves their dog this much? I love you so much. Oh my god, this is the best birthday present my mom could have ever got me, ever. She got me a different painting. I'll show you guys it. But I was like, Mom, if I'm gonna be honest with you, I don't like it. Threw it in the guest room for now, but I think she's gonna get rid of it. But it's like, eh. It's okay, but it's just, it's not my style. Dudes, we got 32K likes on the vlog last time. The 3-minute vlog of me saying, hey guys, I'm gonna start talking on this channel. So that's awesome, bro. I didn't expect that at all. Barely promoted, I posted on my Instagram story and I put it on a channel that I haven't uploaded in 2 years and still 32,000 people decided to like the video. So thank you guys so much for that. Crazy, it only has like 200,000 views also, 32K likes. That's a pretty good ratio. You know, I mean, that means like most of you guys that watched the video decided to leave a like on it. But I think I'm just gonna balance how I upload on that channel because I don't want to burn myself out or anything by any means. So I'm gonna be uploading like 3 times a week on that channel to start, and then I'm gonna be uploading every other day for now, and then I'm gonna start uploading every single day on this channel like probably within the next couple weeks. As soon as I'm like in the groove and I'm like, okay, this is no problem, like this is easy, I'm banging this out, that's when I'm gonna start uploading every single day on this channel. So today's topic that I want to talk about is girls, actually, or I guess just relationships in general, because I know there's some girls that watch this channel as well, but I just mean like relationships when you're younger and you're getting into them. I never even really talked about it. I always like kind of said everything else that's the issue, but one of my biggest problems with like anxiety and even getting depressed over it was girls for some reason. Now that I'm a little bit older and I can understand maybe why it was like that growing up, I think because when I was younger, I was super like just insecure all the time. I didn't really have like a core group of friends where like I was with them every single day. I didn't feel secure in no friend group or nothing. I just played Xbox, you know what I'm saying? And that's how I felt like comfortable and safe and just like, I felt like I mattered. You know what I mean? Just playing Xbox and getting trick shots, I swear to God. Like, that's the only thing in my life where I felt like I belonged. When I played Xbox, when I made videos, like that's the only thing. There's nothing else in my life. I wasn't a part of any sports teams. Like, I didn't do shit. My mom was super protective over me when I was a kid. I wasn't allowed to leave the house too much. I wasn't even allowed to take like the transit bus till I was like 14, bro. Like, think about that. I just wasn't allowed to do shit. So I just played video games all day. You know what I mean? And I liked it. And it's not like it was like a problem for me. I wanted to play video games all day. I wanted to keep doing that. So I guess when I was doing all that, anytime I felt like I had a girl that like I really liked or thought like I fell in love with or something, my like I attached myself to them because I had no one else that I felt like actually cared about me or loved me like that. Like, I know my mom does and my, but at the time, say when I was a kid and stuff, you know what I mean? Like, that's the only person that I felt like that actually liked me for me when I was a kid, you know what I mean? Like relationships and girls and all that shit. So I guess I naturally got into a habit of every time I got with a girl or something, like I got too attached, you know what I mean? And like I would just get too anxious about it, would keep telling myself, do they even like me like that? Or am I getting fucked over? Like, I would just get too anxious, and for that, girls was always a toxic thing for me. I could never just be in a relationship and just enjoy it for what it is and not stress all the bullshit that it comes with. I would just focus solely on the bullshit. And because of that, I've realized that I'm not anywhere near ready for relationships. I have a lot to work on myself for that. So I feel like there's a lot of people that are in the same like wavelength. Whenever I see like these depressed Twitters or something like that, they're always tweeting about relationships and shit. And we're so fucking young that it is so damn silly for us to just get that hung up on relationships and that hung up on like people that are in our lives. Like, I get it, they mean a lot to us in the moment, but it's crazy to me because a girl, like when I was like 13, 14, that I was like in love with and lost my virginity to and everything, I don't even think about her like 9 years later, you know what I mean? Like, I don't even, like, I can't believe that actually happened. Like, I know it happened, but it's like, I don't actually believe that that was like me or anything, you know what I mean? You grow out of all that stuff. It's just another memory, you know what I mean? You're gonna get through it. No relationship, no girl, no guy is gonna ruin your life, you know what I mean? Now I feel like we're in a generation where we get so hung up on relationships and just putting relationships on like social media and all that shit, and that's why like I wanted to keep it super private to me this time, because after all the shit with like Taylor, for example, like that relationship, I made it super public, everyone knew about her, and then after we broke up, bro, people still comment about her to this day. Like, imagine like when I'm like healing and trying to get through it and everything, and everyone's just constantly, you know, tweeting me shit about her, you know what I mean? Like, bro, it got hard for me at that point, and that's why every relationship from there on, like, just not putting it publicly. It's just not happening. Don't see myself making it public for a long time, because I just also have realized that relationships are for me and I don't want them to be public by any means. It's not the world's business, you know, if I'm in a relationship or not. Immo. Because they don't do anything good for relationships, you know, like, What can social media do that's good for your relationship other than try to rip it apart? Like, dude, there's nothing good that can come out of putting your relationship on social media. Like, what good can come from it? I don't know, maybe that's just the way I see it. I always realized also something with myself. Whenever I was single, I would be working on myself more. I would be, you know, just project me. And then whenever I was in a relationship, my mind would be fully focused on the relationship and I would forget to take care of myself, look after myself, and then that would just leave me with more problems after a long period of time. Because you just get so comfortable in a relationship, you know what I mean? So it's good to be solo sometimes. And if you are, to say you just got out of a relationship and you're heartbroken over it, this, that, and the other. Sorry, I didn't mean to go, you're heartbroken. I don't mean to desensitize your feelings. Of course your feelings matter, but I'm just letting you know, you're probably tripping way more than you should. If I'm being real with you, you probably are. We all do. And it's just human, man. We just don't know what to do with ourselves when we lose that person. But it's gonna be okay. I promise you it's gonna be okay. Just work on yourself. Get more into hobbies. Get more into the stuff that actually makes you happy and just get better at it. Like for me, when I first got into like my breakups and all that shit, I just get right in the gym. And that makes me feel good about myself. I play video games, distract myself. And eventually, you're not even distracting yourself anymore. You're just not thinking about it. Because I know in the beginning, you're like, well, I don't want to distract myself. And then the emotions, bro, just move on. But I know exactly how it is, like when you get like in love and emotional and all that shit, like you stop, you don't use your common sense and you don't, like, you're not rational. You pretty much just think emotionally and think, no, did I spit there? Bro, I spit there when I talk and I blew a bubble. Bitch, I hate those, that little bitch go hiss, hiss. She a snake ho, some like a bad kid. I don't listen, baby, these not Advils. These prescription, I just dropped a Xanbar. And my Lipton, I'm living the sweet life, London Tipton. Anyways, what was I saying? I forgot, I got distracted. But also, like a thing for me, whenever I actually realize what it is that's the problem, it helps me deal with it. Like, for example, when I said, I realized that the reason maybe I was so like attached to girls is because of how I was as a kid. I never really felt like anyone like loved me, whatever, whatever. So when I was with a girl, etc. Like when I said all that, knowing that makes me feel better about it. So when, like when I go through that again or when I think about it or all that, I'll understand why I am the way I am. Even when I have like toxic traits and then I see them in my mom, I'm like, oh, you're the reason. You know what I mean? Like it makes me feel a lot better knowing why I'm like this. And then I'm able to just like, you know, work on it and get better at it. So listen guys, if you're going through that shit, you're going through a breakup, you feel like your life's over, you're probably 15 years old, you got your heart broken, life's over, right? There's no, what else are you gonna do with your life? It's fucking over. You just got into a breakup at 15. No, I'm obviously trolling you at this, but I'm sorry. I don't mean to hurt you, because you're 15, you don't even know, you're like, he's just making fun of me right now, isn't he? I'm not, but I just want you to know, like, I promise you, you're gonna be okay. Like, when I first, like, I tried to, like, OD once when I was 14. Right? And a big part of it was my first breakup. And I'm not even gonna lie, I don't even know if I brought that up when I made my Draw My Life or anything, because I was low-key embarrassed to talk about it. I was like, bro, I don't want to let people know that when I was a kid, I almost tried to OD over a girl. Like, that's so whack. And that's what went down. And do you understand if I died back then, how pissed I'd be right now? I mean, I wouldn't know. But bro, thinking about it, that is the dumbest shit I ever could have done in my life. Like I said, I don't even like think about that girl. I don't even know that girl. It's like, never crosses my mind. And I tried to end my life over it when I was a kid. Like, that's some perspective. So when I think about stuff like that, it's like, okay, I know how I felt the way before, so I know how I'm gonna feel in the future. And a big part of it is I never loved myself. Like, I'm just now experiencing self-love for the first time in my whole 23 years of life, like this last few months. Like, I never ever really loved myself like that. I always hated myself. Like I said, I was always super insecure, hated the way I looked, hated all this shit. But then you just end up just realizing that this is the life I got given, gotta make the best of it. Like, what else can you do? You know what I mean? Like, you can compare your life to someone else, you can sit there feeling sorry for yourself, but it's such a waste of time. Just take life that you've been given and just work on it and make it the best possible version that you can. And if it's still pretty shitty, then fuck it, at least you try. The realistic aspect is that there's too many people in this world for all of us to live an amazing life. There's gonna be some of us that make the most of it and do that with themselves, and there's other people that are gonna sit there and they're gonna complain and feel bad for themselves like I was for the last 2 years, and they're just not gonna do shit and not go nowhere. And that's the fact. I don't want to be like, you know, not sensitive or anything to people's feelings, but we just all need to grow the fuck up and look after and take control of our own lives, because no one else is gonna do that for us. No girl, no guy, no one, no friends, no one. Like, you have to do that for yourself. No one's gonna do that. Stop putting yourself, and I'm talking to myself here too, but stop putting yourself so deep into those relationships. Like, I saw what Will Smith said about his wife. He's like, it's not my responsibility to make her happy. It's not her responsibility to make me happy. Like him and Jada. And he's just like, we are both separately happy, and then we share that happiness together. Facts, bro. Like, Will Smith gets it, and that's why he's been with his wife for so long, and that's why he's not divorced right now, like most people. If you need to love yourself, and then whoever you're with needs to love themselves, and then you bring that together, and then you just love each other and yourselves, and everything's good. Then you won't get jealous as much, you won't feel anxious as much, is because there's just so much fucking love in the air, dog. So yeah, that's about all I got on relationships and love and all that ish. Maybe I'm missing something. I think that's about all of it. But yeah, man, just work on yourself. That's pretty much the purpose of this, because that's where I feel like it gets toxic. When you don't love yourself, but you love someone else, and then you expect them to control the way you feel, or you depend your feelings on them. Like, mm-mm. Like, bro, I used to shut down every time, like, I was in an argument with my girlfriend or anything like that. I would just shut down, like, emotionally done. Like, couldn't do shit. So that was always hard, you know? So we don't ever want to put ourselves in those kind of situations. It's just not good for us. But all I got. Sky, anything you want to add? Anything? Oh, yeah? Oh, yeah, you sweet little baby boy. Oh, and by the way, the reason he's not here is that after my dog died and my cat died, my mom didn't want no animals, you know what I mean? Like, we just lost two of our family. Like, we're not gonna try to replace them or anything, you know what I mean? My plan was to leave the California with Sky. Both my pets died. Do you think I'm gonna do that? You know what I mean? I'm not gonna take Sky away from my family. So he's pretty much their dog now, is what I'm trying to say. Like, he lives at my house. I live so close to my house, so it's okay. I can literally just drive. I'm there all the time, so it doesn't matter. I still see Sky all day. I miss you so much. It's gonna suck not having him at my crib anymore, but you know, I'm also in a condo, you know? I'm not gonna put Sky in a condo. He's a dog, he's a husky, he's energetic. You need to be in a house, you need a backyard. You can't be in a condo. It's not cool. I'm not gonna make him go up and down the elevator 8 times a day. It's just not worth it. But yeah, he's pretty much with my family. But don't worry, I'll go home and vlog with him and my family and all that real soon. But yeah, guys, that's all I had to say today about this topic. I love you guys so much. Thank you guys for watching the video. Hopefully you guys took something out of it, and we will see you guys in the next one. Leave a like if you guys enjoyed, and we'll see you guys, yeah, in the next one. Peace out, everybody. Keep it real.